this up into two parts because, well, my video card freaked out for whatever reason. Let's start adding some highlights. I'm gonna put a layer on top of the Venom. Set it to screen. Let's go with and the brush is still set to 100%. See how this looks. Let's pull this opacity down a little bit more. A little bit more. That one either. To this one. I should have colored that, those teeth a little bit yellow. I'm going to change that here in a minute. I'm just going to put some highlights through here. Just these little scattered highlights. I'm gonna leave that. I'm gonna leave it. I'm gonna leave it. I think it looks cool. I'm leaving it. It's there. Tough. It's there. Oops. I'm just going to do some painting directly on this layer. Need a smaller brush than that. It's getting close. It's getting close on the teeth. Multiply. Let's turn this way down. I'm just doing this directly on the main color level for Venom. Put the brush set to multiply. If you don't know, you can move your image around with the space bar. You just tap that space bar, and you can give your image a nudge. Although, everybody probably knows that. But just in case you don't, there's so many shortcuts to this program, some of which I used to know, but mostly forgot. trim tool. Let's see what we get. Something I want to try. Not it. Not what I was looking to open. All right. I just blended, you know, blend those layers in, set the multiply. just going over some of these black lines now. The brush set to screen. Make some of the black little squiggles and stuff in the gums and in the teeth, not black. Not such hard black lines make them look more like gum detail. Which I think looks cool. A little lots of little bumps on the tongue. Honestly, this is probably the most detailed coloring in the entire piece is the tongue. Because doing it practically on the page with grayscale would take a little bit of time. Might not actually work out quite as well as doing it this way. Let's hit this. Yeah. Get on these black lines a little bit. Making the gums look a little more painted than they really are. Yeah, that looks way more painted than it really is. It looks like there's a lot going on there, you know, like it's really time consuming, but it's not. it's not. You know what, let's turn that back down, crank up the size just a little. Multiply. For a sketch this simple, I'm gonna call this done. I mean, really. I can't think of a whole lot more to do to it. It's not bad. But hopefully these two videos give you a better idea of a simple way to color stuff. It's not hard. It's all layers of screen and multiply underneath or on top of your line art. Some layers set the normal, some set the multiply, some set the screen, and it's just all about playing with those layer orders and figuring it out. It's really, really simple, and especially the way I do it, because I like really simple, strong primary colors mostly when coloring even murky, crazy, splattery stuff like I tend to do. Very scribbly, very loose. A lot of times I've got hatching and ink wash and splatter effects everywhere, all over everything. And that's the reason I like to color it so simply and not get into too much, tons of gradients, tons of highlights, tons of special effects, which work great on people who have very tight, clean, crisp styles. But with me, that doesn't work on my stuff. It would be way overkill. It would just muddy the waters and look like garbage. So, hope this turned out okay. If you have any questions, anything, leave a comment. I'll do my best to answer. And thanks for watching, guys. I appreciate it. Later.